Hey y'all, welcome back to another day of Vlogmas. Today I am bringing you another Sims build. Today I'm trying out a shell challenge. This shell was posted by Kayla, aka Lil Simsy, here on YouTube. She's someone that I've been following for quite some time, and she occasionally does these shell challenges, and I've never tried one out before, but when I saw that she posted a December shell challenge, I figured it was the perfect time to try one out since I'm trying to do all sorts of different types of videos this month. So if you're new to the concept, a shell challenge is when a creator posts a shell of a building. It's literally just walls put up and you can turn the building into literally anything that you want. The only rule is that you can't move any of the exterior walls that the creator has put in the build. So I turned this into these two little, I call them artist's lofts. I pictured this build as two townhouses when I first looked at it, and it was kind of a challenge to make the shape work, but that's kind of the fun of a shell challenge. That's why it's called a challenge. So as you can see, I made like a little garage space in this one to kind of make that bump out space work and all of that stuff. I really love how these turned out. I ended up making them two very contrasting townhouses. So this one is this ultra modern, very bougie. I imagined like a photographer or someone who works in the creative industry in more of a digital way living in this build. And then next door, you'll see when we get to it, is this sort of French Parisian style townhouse. It's a little more rundown, a little more rustic, a bit more charming is how I would describe it. I typically don't do modern builds at all, so that was another kind of fun aspect but also challenging aspect of this build for me. I definitely could have been a little more creative. I know it's like a lot of all black decor, which is very stereotypical for modern, but I mean, hey, I typically don't do modern at all, so I pushed my creative limits even if it isn't that creative or out there. And I do really like how it turned out, even though I probably still wouldn't want to live here because it's just modern really isn't my personal style usually. Y'all know me, I love my Victorian, my vampire stuff, my cottage core, my cozy cabin type of things. But I've talked about this before where I really like to sort of make up stories for the builds that I'm making. It just kind of helps me decorate them and personalize them and really get into doing the build. So for this build, I ended up putting this build in Brightchester, which is the little university town in The Sims. It ended up fitting there really well. I wasn't quite sure where I was gonna put this. I was building it and I was like, well, I really like how the exterior of this looks, but because it's so contrasting, these two townhouses that I've done, I don't know where I'm gonna put it where they both fit in. It wasn't gonna fit in San Myshuno because the style of the Parisian townhouse didn't blend at all with the San Myshuno. San Myshuno is more of like a New York style or a San Francisco style. And then it wasn't really gonna fit into Windenburg, which is the European town, because that's more of like, I think it's like Amsterdam. I don't really know. It's a lot of like Tudor style European. And then I tried Brightchester and it fit just perfectly because Brightchester has that mix of old and new in its buildings. So the mix of old and new that I did here ended up working really, really well. I love how it turned out. But basically, I imagine that the two people that live here are both people that go to university. They're apartments, so I imagine them renting out the space. I didn't make it student housing because I wanted to have actual kitchens, but it could very easily be turned into student housing and you can have Sims rent it out for the semester. So I imagine in this one, it's a photographer or a young artist and young digital artist who lives in this space, and next door it's more of a classic artist like a painter or something like that. And I imagine that they don't like each other very much, mostly because of the style of their buildings. So I kind of imagine that in this more French style townhouse that I'm starting on right now, it's owned by maybe this like elderly woman or elderly couple who's had the building for quite some time, and all the other buildings on their block are getting bought out and renovated, and they just refuse to sell their building and they keep renting it out to students at a more affordable price. So the person who lives next door absolutely hates this building because they think it's just an eyesore, it needs to be renovated, and it's really really bringing down the face value of the neighborhood, but then the person who lives in this building hates the next door building, thinks the person is stuck up, they hate that they're gentrifying the neighborhood. So I just imagine that they really don't like each other, even though they're both artists, they're both young, living in this university town, maybe they're both going to university, but they just don't get along. And I think it would be really fun to actually play in this build with these people that don't get along. I haven't played through the university in a while. It's actually really hard to pass university. My sim failed quite a few classes when I sent her through university. So maybe I will actually make the two people that I imagine living in here and have them sort of play out their lives, and who knows, maybe they'll become friends or something by the end of their time living in Brightchester. But I definitely had a little bit of trouble figuring out the layout of both of these, especially with placing the staircases and everything. I really didn't want to put a ladder because realistically, I don't want to climb a ladder to go upstairs every single time I go upstairs. You don't want to climb a ladder every single time you go upstairs. So while the ladders are like a great addition and they help when you're trying to build tiny homes and whatnot, I just didn't think they fit what I was wanting to do with the space. Like, these are actual houses, so they should have staircases in them. But I think that is part of what made the shell challenge so fun for me. Usually my builds just start out as boxes and I have no clue how to turn them into more dimensional builds. Like, this one has a lot of like pop-outs, bump-outs, I don't really know what you would call them, but they're a lot more interesting to look at than just a box. But I always have a hard time actually building builds like this, so it's kind of cool to just have one and just be forced to work within the parameters. I definitely got a little like weird and kooky with the bathroom up here. I was really trying to make it work, but I didn't want the bathroom to be too big and take up too much of the upstairs space. So I ended up doing was just having the shower and the toilet inside the actual bathroom, and then I put the sink outside of the bathroom, because I've definitely seen this before in like the tenement style New York apartments. I've actually seen ones where they just have the bathtub or shower literally in the common area, but I've also seen ones where they have the shower and the toilet in a room, but then they either just have the kitchen sink or they have the sink outside of the bathroom. So I thought it really fit in with like the kind of weird, quirky, old charm of this build that I was going for. And I mean, it fits the space well, like this little bathroom corner with the sink and the bathroom supplies on the shelf ends up like fitting really well into the space, I think. So even though it's kind of weird, that's kind of what makes it fun. And each of these buildings has their own outdoor space too, which I absolutely love. So this one has this cute little garden. I feel like it's very cottagecore. It looks like if you search cottagecore garden on Pinterest, you would find this. And I would love to hang out here and paint in the garden, even though I can't paint for the absolute life of me. And then for next door, I ended up making a little rooftop lounge space, which you'll see in a minute. Creating the living room is a little bit of a challenge because there's not many old looking couches in the game, which I get, because usually people don't want to have like an old rundown Sims build. People play the Sims to live the fantasy, so people like to build more luxurious houses and things like that. But I like how it ended up turning out. I almost didn't put a TV in it. I was like, it wouldn't be kind of funny if there wasn't a TV in here, but it ended up being a nice way to fill the space. I decided to put in this like very, very old style TV from the Ego Lifestyle Pack. I've never used it before and I love how it turned out. And I'm just like putting all these random touches around. I ended up putting a lot of stuff under the staircase because I figured if I lived in this space, I would definitely use the staircase as storage. And since I headcanoned the person living here as a painter, I put a lot of painting supplies and canvases underneath the staircase. I definitely could see that staircase getting all dusty and full of things underneath it. And at this point, I'm just doing a lot of little decor things, finishing touches to really give the place character and charm. If I chose to live in one of these two spaces, I obviously would choose this more French style one. It just fits my personality and my vibe a lot more. But I'd be really curious which of the two of these you would live in if you could live in one of them. And now I'm working on the little rooftop lounge space. This is the one really big selling point of the modern one for me. I think rooftop hangout spaces are super, super fun. And I think the way I decorated it ended up fitting the space really well. I was kind of worried that it just wasn't gonna vibe well. The only other time I've done like a rooftop hangout in The Sims was like a very with that New York City style townhouse that I did a while back, and I made the rooftop very like a college party hangout space, and I didn't want to do that for this, and I think it turned out really nice in my opinion. So this house is available to play on the Sims 4 gallery. You can search my username. My username is Carol Bellevay, or you can just search the hashtag yourgirlcath. If you do end up playing in this, let me know. It'd make me really happy to see some of you guys playing in this. Feel free to like tweet me screenshots or something on Twitter if you want to. But here we are, just going into screenshots now. So yeah, I love how this turned out. I was kind of having a hard time with it at first, and I almost wasn't gonna keep going with it, and I ended up doing something really different for me, really fun, definitely pushed my creative boundaries a little bit with it. So I'm happy with how this turned out, and I hope that you guys like it as well. Thank you so much for hanging out with me. I definitely am going to be doing more Sims builds this month, so if you have any build styles you'd like to request, feel free to do so. I definitely want to get outside of my creative box or creative comfort zone a little bit this month. But thank you for watching. I love you guys, and hopefully I will see you in my next video. Bye!